Good morning, Lobos. I'm Aaron.
And I'm Darrell, and this is Lobo TV.
Today is Friday, March 25th, 2022. Pack Friday is today. However, it will be in the morning with classes in the afternoon.
Today's weather will be sunny with a high of 67 and a low of 43. This weekend will be nice mid-70s.
Today's holiday is Waffle Day. What do you think, waffles or pancakes? I'm team both.
I prefer waffles, they're just better.
On this day in the year 31 was the first Easter. Also on this day in 1954, RCA manufactured the first color TV set. It had a 12-inch screen and was $1,000, which would be $9,547 today when adjusted for
inflation. Today's
Sarah
famous birthday is Sarah Jessica Parker, who was born in 1965. Larry Page, co-founder of Google, was also born on this day in 1973.
Today's quote from Sarah Jessica Parker, Parker, I developed a really strong work ethic, and I don't take anything for granted.
Today's picture of the day is from an edged landscape in Argentina. Little known fact, Roy is 5% Argentine.
March is Women's History Month, something we celebrate at South. Check this out.
Let's take a look at this quick video.
March is Women's History Month. It's a time we set aside to honor women's contributions in science, business, sports, social movements, and so many other fields. For centuries in America, women's contributions in these fields were often overlooked. As a result, they were omitted from history. That's why we celebrate Women's History Month and the opportunity it gives us all to get a more complete picture of our American history. It's important that we use times like this to teach new generations about those women we all know, like Rosa Parks, whose refusal to surrender her seat to a white passenger on a bus helped launch the effort to end racial segregation in America. Like Susan B. Anthony, an abolitionist who became one of the leading figures in the movement to gain the right to vote for women. And like Claire Booth Luce, the first American woman appointed to a major ambassador post. This month also gives us an opportunity to learn about those women whose names we don't know as well. Like Alice Ball, an African-American chemist who in the early 20th century developed the first successful treatment for leprosy, a debilitating disease that once left its victims ostracized from society. And like journalist Nellie Bly, who posed as a mental patient in 1887 to go undercover in a women's mental asylum in New York City, to expose the terrible conditions patients were subjected to. Her report led to lasting institutional reforms in mental health care. And like chemist Stephanie Kwolek, who in 1965 created a lightweight and durable new fiber that later became Kevlar, which is used to create bulletproof vests and helmets that protect the lives of our law enforcement and military. Women have invented new medicines, fought as heroes on our battlefields, and enforce the laws in our communities. They led in the effort to end slavery. They have created businesses and built hospitals, and they fought to secure their own right to vote. Women have played pivotal roles in building this country. The United States wouldn't be the economic superpower and the world's beacon of liberty without their contributions. On the home front, on the war front, and in the workplace, women have served and shaped our great nation. That's why Women's History Month is such an important opportunity for us to pause and honor their profound contributions. As we recognize them, let's also honor the everyday women who make our families, communities, economy, military, and nations so strong. The Heritage Foundation is deeply proud to honor them all, not only during Women's History Month, but indeed every day of the year.
That's it for today's intro. Peace out.
Peace out.
How do you say the word GIF?
I say GIF.
GIF, you pronounce GIF.
Yes.
This is the wrongest thing that a person can do.
I say GIF. Some people say GIF, like a bunch of dummies.
Yeah, GIF, it's not Jiffy peanut butter.
A GIF. I call it a GIF.
Wait, you would call it a GIF?
No, it's GIF. If you say it any other way, you're wrong.
I've heard computer people say GIF before.
It's kind of like gift. It's just missing the T.
But is GIF short for something?
GIF, graphics interchange format. That makes sense.
Nobody says graphics.
Graphics is a hard G.
So many words are not pronounced the way they're supposed to be.
Which is fine, but this word should be pronounced GIF. Then you should have used a J.
If you coin an abbreviation, you don't get to coin how it's pronounced.
GIF is fine, but it doesn't seem right.
I'm just gonna call JPEGs GPEGs now.
People can say GIF, people can say GIF, people can say GIF, or whatever
GIF.
They want. I mean, I don't care what people do.
Let us know in the comments what you think.
Well, here I say GIF. And here's the only place
Kenny's,
I use GIF.
In Kenny's bedroom.
I whisper it to myself GIF. After I talk to someone. I'm at my desk, I'm like, oh yeah, did you see that GIF? That was really good.
I'm just like, GIF.
If you invent or make something, you determine how it's pronounced. It's GIF, folks. GIF.
Hold on,
Etsy's phone has disrupted Lobo TV 9 times this semester.
Right.
Who has it? I need it. I'm looking for it. Where to go?
Someone's
bringing me back my phone. Can I go charge my phone? Can I go get my charger for my phone?
Where it says 12 inches, start at 8 had.
Don't say I'm not lying.
Yeah, no.
All right, here we go.
No.
All right.
A few moments later.
It had.
No. So we're stopping recording because your Etsy needs an iPhone charger?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
I'm a good person.